channel. Curious about those cool animations on my YouTube shorts? Well, here's the magic. It is AI-powered creativity with stable diffusion. Today, we're embarking on a learning journey, setting it up locally with automatic 1111. Whether you're a tech whiz or just enjoy exploring new ideas, buckle up, this is for anyone who wants to unlock their creative potential. Remember those eye-catching animations? I create them daily on my YouTube shorts. There's always something new. Sure, my IT background helps. You don't need to be a coding master to use Stable Diffusion. We're starting beginner-friendly, guiding you through the first steps into this incredible AI world. There are different ways to install Stable Diffusion, but we'll use Automatic 1111 Web UI Installer because it's easy for beginners. But heads up, the developer isn't actively updating it anymore. But nonetheless, it's a great choice for those starting out. Before we dive in, a friendly reminder that Stable Diffusion loves powerful, beefy graphics card, GPU. While I'm using a mid-spec laptop with GTX 1060, 6GB of VRAM, it is still possible, but expect a little bit longer generation times. Well, Google Colab is a cool alternative if your computer struggles. Remember, I could easily use a high-end laptop or a desktop, but I want to show you achievable options you can connect with. So now, let's get started. Okay, first, head over to the Automatic 1111 Web UI Installer GitHub page. I'll leave all the links in the description. As you can see, Empire Media Science has rendered this launcher obsolete, but we can still use this. We want to go to releases. I already downloaded this, so I'm gonna install. It's pretty straightforward. I'll leave everything by default so it's easy for you guys to follow. Okay, clean install. You can create this launcher into any folder you want. I'm just gonna leave it and then I'll click install. It will take a while. I'm done. Minimize this. And then you will see this. Click on run the launcher, double click the downloaded file and follow the instructions. It's pretty straightforward. So you can see it's actually downloading all the necessary files. You will get this prompt if you're doing it first time. No model was found on your installation. Do you want to download the Stable Diffusion 1.5 base model, which I already have? But if you guys don't, by all means, because it's going to take a while for it to download. So have patience. I'll click no. So this is the menu. Click, I'll check this, and my laptop has 6GB of VRAM. I'm going to click low VRAM, enable XFormers, and then I'm going to click launch web UI. Okay, okay, it's all right. And then I'm gonna click again, yes, no, launch. Don't worry about that, just restart the launcher so it will download Python for you. It's gonna take a while, so don't be surprised if you see all this foreign stuff. Pretty straightforward. Okay, I actually skipped most of that part because it was gonna take a while. It probably bore you, but if it's done correctly, it will pop up something like this, what you see on screen. Basically, we have already installed the launcher, so we're gonna be setting up Stable Diffusion for beginners. First thing first, I'll go to settings, and then this is my workflow. So everyone will have their own preference. Why I'm doing this, so at least beginners won't feel lost. So I'm gonna set up VAE. This is for future videos. I'm gonna click apply settings. You will see Stable Diffusion checkpoint. So you have the sensors, the checkpoint. I've actually downloaded quite a few. So once you're done, you just click reload UI. you can see the stable diffusion VAE. Alright, so since I've already downloaded the checkpoints on the models, this is what I've been using. Alright, so CyberRealistic, epiCRealism, NightVision XL, POLYHEDRON, and Revanimated. So I'm gonna copy those to where Stable Diffusion is installed. It's under Documents. Go to Web UI. Go to Models, and then Stable Diffusion. Just paste. Okay, so we're done copying. So I'll leave all the links in the description, and you are free to download different models or checkpoints. Okay, today in this video, we're gonna do the most basic, which is image generation. And you already copied all this, you go back to the browser, refresh, and you will see the checkpoints loaded up here. And now it's time to play. We're gonna do a very basic image. So first, you would have to key in any prompt, anything that you wanna generate. Alright, whatever you have in mind, feel free to add your prompts. Since I'm using an Asus laptop, I'm gonna put Asus ROG laptop on a sandy beach, blue skies, 8K, highly detailed. Alright, very straightforward, very simple. I'll be using CyberRealistic, and since this is just a demo, don't worry about adjusting all this. I'm gonna be using the width and height 512 512, so it will at least generate faster on this 6GB VRAM model. I'm gonna click on generate. So it's less than a minute, depending on the models. If you are using a very good computer or laptop, this will be even much more faster. So you will see this image on screen. Alright, you can save the image by clicking this diskette and then download. There you go. It's not the best quality, but because I'm using 512 by 512, that's CyberRealistic. If I only use epiCRealism, I'll just need to click and then it will load up. You can see here processing. Once it's done, again you can click generate. Can see different models, different image generation, but the keyboard really looks ugly, but it's fine. This is just a demo. Okay, we'll use NightVision XL photorealistic model. It's done loading. Click generate. You can actually interrupt or skip if you feel that you want to add on different prompts here. We'll go through all that prompt generation, prompt engineering. We'll go through all that in future videos. So NightVision XL photorealistic checkpoint model gave me this. Almost look exactly as my laptop here. Not really. It's still the keyboard. Looks bad, but it's all right. I'm gonna use Polyhedron. Generate. So all these images that you've generated will be saved on this folder. You just need to click on this, and there you go. So Polyhedron gave me this. Again, if you're gonna click on generate, generate until to the point that you've get the image that you want. Alright, so this is what you get. Alright, I think that's about it. We'll explore extensions like the forum and more in future videos, expanding your creative side. And in this video, I'm introducing you the most basic stable diffusion image generation. So I hope you guys enjoy this video, and I hope you guys have fun playing around with this. As you can see here, we'll go through everything step by step, so you don't feel left behind. If you have any questions, feel free to comment down below. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell to stay tuned for the next chapter. That's it for stable diffusion installation. I hope you guys learned something today. Hopefully this simple guide got you started on this AI journey. Thanks for watching.